Life consists of two elements, noise and silence, or rather, excitement and peace. And I'm currently trying to figure out which is better.
Hang on, see if I can actually get in it. Have you got the ignition key?
What you want to drink?
I don't know, I'm in my Bugatti right now.
So I took a trip to two polar opposite places, London and Wales.
There's mountains on Mars and riverbeds too. Infinite stars and there's me and you.
Drippy number one. Drippy number two.
There's nothing he's doing, just keep on moving and be here now with me.
Double. Go on, double onions.
get him in.
Both places gave off a completely different vibe. Wales offered me a haunted looking church, whereas London greeted me with an opera singer and an unexpectedly fast train. Harrods is simple. Look.
We guessed, me and Flinny from Flan.
I guessed £110
for this.
Don't buy. I mean, not everything was expensive.
That's the cheapest thing, isn't it?
Isn't it? £2.50, bargain.
That's actually
it's not Harrods, mate.
Harrods taster.
Is it good?
No.
But most things were.
Just why?
Harrods does a great job at making you feel poor. I mean, this watch is
probably worth as much as your car.
I mean, seriously, look at that. Like, what is that? Although Harrods is expensive, it's just super exciting to see how mad all the prices are. And without exciting places like Harrods, we both just get hungry for adventure. Speaking of hunger. Now, there's one thing that places like Wales just do not have. Ladies and gentlemen, the nightlife.
Dance, 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 let it be. Dance all over me.
But you see, London has one big downfall. Sure, there's a few green spaces here and there, but London just doesn't compare when it comes to scenery.
Come on and dance, 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 let it be.
And just appreciate this piece while you can, because I can assure you. It won't last long. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you, Madame Tussauds.
Madame Three Swords.
It's basically just a bunch of wax models of famous people, but they're super realistic.
It's kind
of
mad.
They had James Bond, Shrek, Winston Churchill, Zizem, Anthony Joshua, yeah. King Kong.
Bruv.
They even had a Flynn Smith. Like, how realistic does that look? They also had a punch-in thing, which my dad demonstrated beautifully.
Yeah, like that's mega hard. Oh yeah, brilliant.
We then entered a phone box.
Well, I'm in.
Got scammed by the phone box.
Listen to the hits.
Nine.
Hash. I don't know. Sorry, I can only.
Nice.
And then left the phone box.
That's good, isn't I'm it? Hanging up.
Then the best attraction of the whole place was waiting for us. But in order to get to it, we had to go to
the cells.
Oh my god.
After my dad asked a very reasonable question, this random guy in a red coat told us to be confident.
We're confident.
But unfortunately, Flynn wasn't confident enough.
Nose. It was very fun.
John Stones?
Oh, yeah. I tickled his nose.
Oh.
John Christie put bodies in the
wall. Oh, lovely.
And with that, we were free.
I'll get him first.
Okay.
Yeah.
The car actually turns itself. You made English exam bad.
This is crazy. A new cathedral arose from the sky.
that guy? He's I don't know. You've got about that, sir. We need to get out now.
I think we need a little break from all those flashing lights and loud noises, so let's switch them.
Wait, hang on. At the end of all of that, there may or may not be a 4D Marvel Cinema Dome experience.
Oh. 4D means that you can not only see the film in 3D, but you can also feel what happens in the film.
Oh, that's great.
Oh, no.
And there was also this thing in the back of the chair that just, it punched you dead hard.
Oh, ow. Oh my day.
Visiting Port Merion definitely gave me the other side of the equation. And because of that, I think I've finally figured it out. You see, we mustn't fill our days with things that we're told to do, but rather we need to do what feels right. Not what feels easy, but what feels right. I'll give you an example.
Make myself so I feel better, I'm gonna do a YouTube intro. Yes guys, so today we are on the London Eye. Here we go.
Literally.
Is it now? Look at this. I love being 400, well, about 200 foot in the air right now.
We're not even there yet.
Oh my god, we're not even halfway. We're not even halfway to the halfway point. I feel absolutely horrendous.
You don't feel amazing.
I feel amazing, you're right, you're so right. This is the best thing I've ever been on. I love standing up. I just love standing up and I love getting close to the edge. I love getting close to the edge and looking down and looking up. Oh my god, this is actually disgusting. I'm literally shaking.
Come on, push-ups take mind off. Push-ups make everything go away.
Yeah!
19, 20, do you like the shake?
I love the shake. And we're at the top. We are at the tippy top.
Well, this is a London Eye.
We're on the decline. Oh, that's actually a sick shot, dude. I can't even like...
I'll hold it.
Don't touch me.
I'll hold it.
That's just disgusting.
That's
the finish line. It's a good view, you just have to be in the worst position possible to get it. I'm very ready to get off.
We did it!
Thank you, Lord. I'm alive.
The absolute last thing I wanted to do was to step onto that eye and be sent 400 feet in the air. But I knew the regret of not doing it would be so much worse. I had a headache, I felt a bit ill, I really needed a poo. But I still did it. And I'm so glad I did.
We did it!
I've been battling over which is better, excitement or peace. But I've now realised that that's the wrong question, and in fact, it's not a question. You should enjoy the moments of silence, and you should also enjoy the moments of excitement. then, and only then, will you realise how great life is.